I know, from being your dictator, that we will all do fine. Meeting new people, venturing in the world, the class of 2015 will only improve the society we just entered. Not one person sitting here today is the same as the person next to you, and that's what makes this class so special. Our class is growing up. Soon we will be done with college, working, and even starting families. We, as a class, are expected to carry on and become successful. And from my experiences with you, I have no doubt in my mind that we will succeed. And so I'll leave you with this. We did it. Now let's do more.
The class of 2015 would like to dedicate this song to one of our former classmates who we lost back in 2010, Ms. Cheyenne Nicole Dennis.
Thank you. I'm Dr. Kelly Coffin, superintendent here at Tecumseh Public Schools, and I first want to say congratulations to the class of 2015. We are so proud of your achievements and all you have done to get to this point, graduation day. We'd like to take a moment now to recognize our valedictorian and salutatorian. First, we'll start with the valedictorian. This year's valedictorian is the daughter of Jeffrey and Jennifer Krieger. Jordan Krieger, our valedictorian, with a grade point average of 4.268, is now, please come up to the podium.
Together, we arrived here for the very first time, all caught like deer in the headlights as we scrambled to find our classes. For the most part, we kept to ourselves, trying to fit in as we adjusted to this new and unfamiliar building. As the days, weeks, and months went by, however, we slowly became more and more comfortable with the help of our truly impassioned faculty. Our teachers not only came in early and stayed late, but also found a way to make even the millionth verb conjugation just a little more enjoyable. The counselors and office staff handled our schedules, absences, and oh so many tardies with incredible patience. And our coaches pushed us to reach our goals and even at times surpass them.
No, I'm gonna go up.
Still, school does not end in the classroom. None of us would be here today without the support of our parents. You're the ones who drove us to all of our things until we could drive ourselves, and even then you still drove to continue watching us. To each and every one of you, no simple thank you could ever really express our gratitude. And now, after what at first felt like a lifetime, but now it just seems like the blink of an eye, we meet again for the very last time, united as we were on that first day. We may have had our disputes and our drama, but this impossible family we've created still stays together each step of the way. I say impossible because, unlike most typical families, we are all so vastly different. Indeed, despite the fact that today we sit here in front of you in identical caps and gowns, I can tell you we're anything but ordinary. We've proven to be a very competitive and determined class. Just watch a badminton tournament or a quiz bowl match. The gamut of our talent spans remarkably far, not just as a whole, but individually as well. And most of all, we know who we are. And being a part of this family means that we have the confidence to be ourselves, whether that means wearing a unicorn mask and throwing glitter on a few people, doing a Joker impersonation so realistic that it gives the entire classroom chills, or putting on a big poofy wedding dress and marrying one of your best friends. We look at these memories fondly as this chapter comes to a close. As I've said, we've become confident, determined, and comfortable with who we are and who we may become. These assets will carry on through the rest of our lives. I challenge you to use these tools to do something great in your life, something truly unimaginable. Whatever inspires you, whatever you're passionate about, and whatever you may love, just do it. One person cannot single-handedly change the world, but a class of about 200 passionate young adults striving to live out their full potential definitely can. As we leave here, we have the opportunity to utilize unbelievable technology and resources to pursue our dreams, and in the process, inspire our posterity to do the same. I'm not promising you that this will be easy. In fact, you'll be met with obstacles much greater than those you've ever dealt with before. The challenges do not end here, they simply change. And it's the motivation to clear each hurdle that, in the end, will truly make you successful. We have the potential to be doctors, innovative engineers, lawyers, CEOs, lieutenants, maybe even presidents. We just have to get out there, full speed ahead, to do the great things you and I know that we can. So, class of 2015, in the words of Mr. Mossberg, are you thirsty? Or are you window shopping?
I'd like to introduce our salutatorian. This year's salutatorian is the son of Robert Terry and Diana Cook. Our salutatorian, with a grade point average of 4.214, is James Terry.
First off, I would like to say congratulations, 2015. We did it. We have walked these hallways for 4 years now, wondering where life is going to take us. Today, we take the first step of our journey into the beginning of our lives. We have wandered in and out of these classrooms, not only learning valuable knowledge and preparing ourselves for the future, but discovering who each and every one of us are. High school is a place where our true identities are revealed. We all, in some form, better understand who we are as people. We determined our likes, our dislikes, our flaws, our impurities, our strengths, our weaknesses, and so much more. We also have come to realize our roles within Tecumseh High School and within our community. This realization of our roles within society coincides with the discovery of ourselves. So looking forward to the rest of our lives, I challenge each and every one of you to continue to find yourself and to find your niche within whatever ecosystem you end up becoming a part of, whether it is back here in Tecumseh or on the other side of the world. Happiness and great things will come to those of us who know who we are and who utilize the strength to improve our society or community as a whole. But this is not a goal that should be forced, rushed into, or even taken too seriously. Let things come to you and just be yourself going forward into life. Using the words of my friend Granny and Cheats is over there, we all should be down to clown around and score some touchdowns. Grant realizes that big opportunities and wonderful things, as in the touchdowns, will come to those of us who continue to find ourselves, those of us who let things come to them, and those of us who never stress too heavily or take their goals or even life too earnestly, as in the clowning around. Knowing ourselves and playing to our strengths will ensure that any goal we set for ourselves is attainable. So once again, I challenge this class to pursue their true selves and their true callings. Let nothing stand in our way. Keeping the tradition of our Terry Salutatorians alive, I end my speech today by saying thank you, and roll drop.
Symphony. We'll play now.